Hello, this is Dr. Aparna Sajjan from VPKBIET, Baramati. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss how to solve the numericals on the ultimate analysis of coal. We know that ultimate analysis of coal involves the determination of carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen and sulfur percentages by experiments, and oxygen is determined indirectly. So, in the determination of carbon and hydrogen, combustion method is used. The carbon and hydrogen are present in the coal, are converted into carbon dioxide and water vapors in the combustion tube in presence of oxygen. The amount of carbon dioxide formed is determined by the increase in weight of KOH tube, because KOH absorbs the carbon dioxide, and the weight of H2O is determined by knowing the increase in weight of CaCl2 present in the U-tube, because anhydrous calcium chloride absorbs the water vapors. So with the help of this, weight of water vapors formed in the experiment and weight of carbon dioxide formed in the experiment, we can calculate the weight of carbon and hydrogen, and then we can convert it into percentage carbon and percentage hydrogen. So 44 gram of carbon dioxide contains 12 gram of carbon. Therefore, W gram of coal contains this much weight of carbon dioxide, and 12 divided by 44 will give the conversion from carbon dioxide to carbon. 100 gram of coal, means percentage, contains WCO2 into 12 divided by 44 into 100 divided by coal. So this gives the percentage carbon. Similarly, 18 gram of water vapors contain 2 gram of hydrogen. Therefore, whatever the weight of H2O formed in the experiment, it contains this much amount of hydrogen, that is weight of water vapors into 2 divided by 18. So 2 divided by 18 is the conversion factor that converts water vapors to hydrogen. The percentage hydrogen will be weight of H2O into 2 divided by 18, the conversion factor, into the percentage factor, that is 100 divided by weight of coal. In the ultimate analysis, nitrogen is determined by Gildal's method, by converting the nitrogen into ammonia. So after converting this ammonia in terms of acid, in the experiment, the ammonia is absorbed in the known volume of standard acid, like HCl. So we get that 1 mole of acid is equivalent to 14 gram of nitrogen. Therefore, whatever the volume of acid is consumed by ammonia, that contains how much amount of nitrogen. So this volume of acid neutralized by ammonia is determined by carrying out two titrations at the end of Gildal's experiment. One is blank titration with the total volume of acid titrated against alkali, and the other is back titration with the ammonia. Whatever the flask is there which contains ammonia, it is titrated against the standard alkali. So V2 minus V1 will give the blank minus back titration readings will give the volume of acid that was neutralized by ammonia. So that much ammonia will contain how many gram of nitrogen? So it comes to 14 divided by 1000, that is 14 divided by 1000 into V2 minus V1 and normality of acid. The percentage nitrogen will be volume of acid neutralized by ammonia into normality of acid into 14 divided by 1000 into 100 divided by weight of coal, the percentage factor. Similarly, in the ultimate analysis, sulfur is determined by the Baum method. And in this Baum method, whatever the acid extract is there, it is treated with barium chloride to get the barium sulfate precipitate. The barium sulfate precipitate is filtered through Ottmann filter paper, then it is dried, ignited, and then weighed. So whatever the amount of barium sulfate is obtained, it is W gram. 1 mole of barium sulfate contains 233 gram BaSO4. That is, the formula weight of BaSO4 is 233. Barium 137 plus sulfur 32 and oxygen 16 into 4 times. So by adding all the weights, we get 233. So in this 233 gram BaSO4, there will be 32 gram sulfur. So whatever the barium sulfate is formed in the experiment, that amount of barium sulfate contains how many grams of sulfur? So it is weight of BaSO4 into 32 divided by 233. This is the conversion factor that converts barium sulfate into sulfur. And percentage sulfur will be weight of BaSO4 into conversion factor into percentage factor, that is 100 upon weight of coal. So with the information, we can do the calculations. So let us see how to calculate the CHNS percentages from the given observations. Three observations are given. The first observation, 2.1 gram of coal is burnt in the combustion tube and increase in weight of anhydrous CaCl2 is 0.53 and that of KOH tube is 5.73 gram. So with this observation, we can calculate the percentage carbon and hydrogen present in the coal sample given. Similarly, second observation, 0.75 gram coal in the Jeldahl's experiment produced ammonia that was absorbed in 50 ml 0.12 normal acid, and this acid required 39 ml of 0.12 NaOH for back titration. So 50 is the total volume of acid, that is blank titration reading. 39 is the volume of acid, that is for back titration, and 0.12 is the normality given, and this is the weight of coal. So with this we can calculate the percentage nitrogen. The third observation, washings of boom pot when 1.9 gram of coal sample in boom calorimeter experiment is treated with barium chloride that gave 0.41 gram BaSO4. So in the last observation, weight of BaSO4 is given 0.41 gram and weight of coal is given 1.9. So with this we can calculate percentage sulfur. So let us see how the percentage carbon and hydrogen are determined or calculated. So coal sample 2.1 gram, increase in weight of CaCl2 that gives weight of H2O 0.53, it is given. Increase in weight of KOH tube, weight of carbon dioxide is given 5.73, the first observation readings. So percentage hydrogen is weight of CaCl2 increase 0.53, 2 divided by 18 conversion factor, 100 divided by weight of coal 2.1 percentage factor, the answer after calculation 2.8. The percentage carbon, the increase in weight of KOH, that is 5.73 into 12 divided by 44, the conversion that converts carbon dioxide to carbon, and the percentage factor, that is 100 divided by 2.1, the percentage, the amount of coal. Therefore, percentage carbon comes to 74.41. Let us see how the nitrogen is determined. The weight of coal is 0.75. Volume for blank titration, 50 is indirectly given. Volume for back titration, 39. And the normality is 0.12. So with this, the volume of acid neutralized by ammonia is calculated. 50 minus 39, 11. And percentage of nitrogen in coal is volume of acid neutralized by ammonia into normality of acid 0.12, 14 divided by 1000, the conversion factor, and the percentage factor, that is 100 divided by weight of coal. coal, 0.75. So after calculating, the answer comes to 2.46. Lastly, using the third observation, the weight of coal sample used in the bomb calorimeter experiment, it is 1.9 gram, and the weight of barium sulfate formed at the end is 0.41 gram. So percentage sulfur is weight of BaSO4, the conversion factor 32 divided by 233, which converts barium sulfate into sulfur, and 100 divided by weight of coal. So 0.41 is the weight of BaSO4 and 1.9 is the weight of coal. The answer comes to 2.96. So at the end, we have written all the results of this numerical, the percentages that we have calculated. Let us see another experiment calculations. Calculate CHS percentages from the following observations of coal in the ultimate analysis. So 0.18 gram on burning in combustion chamber, presence of oxygen is there, increase in weight of CaCl to U tube by 0.09 gram and that of KOH tube is 0.5 gram. Percentage carbon and hydrogen we have to calculate here. Then 0.65 gram coal was combusted in bomb calorimeter and the washings of bomb on treatment with barium chloride solution gave 0.031 gram BaSO4 dry precipitate. So with this we have to calculate the percentage sulfur. So again we will write down what are the data given. Weight of coal sample in the first observation was 0.18 gram and the increase in weight of CaCl to U tube is given, which is nothing but the weight of water vapors absorbed by the CaCl to 0.09 gram, and the increase in weight of KOH tube is given, which is nothing but the weight of carbon dioxide absorbed by the KOH, that is 0.5 gram. So percentage hydrogen is increase in weight of CaCl to 0.09, 2 divided by 18 conversion into 100 divided by 0.18 percentage. So the answer comes to 5.55. And the percentage carbon is increase in weight of KOH, that is 0.5 into 12 divided by 44 conversion factor and into 100 divided by weight of coal 0.18. After solving, we get 75.75%. In the second observation, the weight of coal sample is given as 0.65 gram and the weight of barium sulfate formed as a dry precipitate is given 0.031 gram. So with these two observations, we can calculate percentage sulfur, weight of barium sulfate 0.031 into 32 divided by 233, the conversion factor to convert barium sulfate to barium, and then 100 divided by weight of coal 0.65. So after solving, we get the percentage 0.65. So we have calculated in this numerical carbon, hydrogen and sulfur. So at the end we have written the results. Then in this experiment of ultimate analysis, only one observation is given. 0.5 gram of coal sample is completely combusted in a combustion tube and the increase in weight of CaCl2 is given 0.2 gram and that of KOH tube is given 1.2 gram. So calculate the percentage of carbon and hydrogen in the given coal sample. Only one observation, so only the percentage carbon and hydrogen has to be calculated in this numerical. Using weight of coal 0.5 gram, increase in weight of CaCl2 U tube, which is nothing but the weight of water vapors absorbed 0.2 gram and increase in weight of KOH tube 1.2 gram, which is nothing but the weight of carbon dioxide absorbed. So after calculating, the percentage of hydrogen 0.2 into 2 divided by 18 into 100 divided by 0.5, the answer comes to 4.44, and the percentage of carbon 1.2 into 12 divided by 44 into 100 divided by weight of coal 0.5. So after solving, the answer comes to 65.5. 4, 5. So only two observations, only one observation and two calculations were there. So therefore, we have written the percentages. In the another numerical, only one observation is there, that too it is Jaldal's experiment. So in this experiment, we have to calculate the percentage nitrogen with the given data. So 1.6 gram of coal sample in Jaldal's experiment, which was absorbed, ammonia formed was absorbed in 50 ml 0.1 n sulfuric acid, and the resultant solution required 28 ml of 0.1 n NaOH for complete neutralization of H2SO4 in back titration. The reading for blank was 50 ml. Find the percentage of nitrogen in the coal sample. So blank is 50 and back is 28. It is given. Weight of coal sample 1.6. Blank reading 50. Back reading 28. And the normality of, actually it is H2SO4, 0.1 is given. So volume of H2SO4 neutralized by ammonia is VNH3, that is blank minus back, P2 minus V1, 50 minus 28, it comes to 22. So the percentage nitrogen in coal is volume of acid neutralized by ammonia, that is 22, into normality of acid, that is 0.1, normality of H2SO4. By mistake we have written here HCl. Then 14 divided by 1000 into 100 divided by weight of coal, that is 1.6. So after solving we get 1.925%. So this is how we can solve the numericals on ultimate analysis of coal. So this is the end of video lecture. Thank you for watching.